Hey guys, welcome back to Naughty Threats. In case you're new here, do subscribe and hit the bell icon to get all the future updates. So today's video is a very interesting one. It's very easy design, especially for beginners, so watch till the end. It's a surprise video, so I'm not going to show what I'm exactly going to teach. So you guys watch, and now let's get started. For today's design, I am using crochet hook number 10 and 6 strands of silk thread here. And these kind of gold beads. So these are teardrop shaped and gold in color. So they are thin on one side and they have this round end on the other side. You can use regular pipes as well to work this design. Any long bead is suitable for this design. So I've already made a knot to the thread here. The right side of the fabric is facing on top, and now we'll start by fixing the knot. So I'll fix the knot here, pierce into the fabric, wind the thread around the needle, pull a loop, and then work one chain. That's how you fix the knot. Once we have the knot in place, we'll take a bead in the needle. So this time the wide side of the needle is going in first. I'm going to push this, lock it using a chain stitch, and do one more chain. Now I'll add one more bead, but this time I am going the opposite side. The narrow side is going first. Slide it and lock it using a chain stitch. So when you fix it, this is how it will look. In case you are using something which is similar on both the sides or same on both the sides, you don't have to keep this point in mind. But since this bead is thin on one side and round on other side, that is why this is the order you will have to put it in. Now here I'm going to fix this using a single crochet. I'll work 3 single crochets here. One next to the other. So after 3 single crochets, I'll again add the bead same way. So every time I'm adding my first bead, the wide side is going inside. Knot it using a chain stitch, do one extra chain, and then for my second bead, I will do it the other way around. Lock it with a chain stitch again. So now you will have to look at the distance. Whatever distance you have worked this first one, first V, same distance you will have to work the second one as well. So the baseline is extremely simple. Again, I will continue with 3 single crochets. And add a bead. So I have worked till here. You will continue working the same till you reach the end of the pallu, and I'm going to trim off this thread here. Pull the loop that is on the needle and we'll make a knot here. So since I started with only one stitch, I have ended with one stitch. You don't have to do this part in the starting and ending, but in case if you do it, then you'll have to do on both the sides so that both the ends look alike. So this one I'm going to just knot it and trim off the excess thread. So this design is extremely simple. If in case you are just starting to do crochet designs, then you should definitely try this design. It doesn't take long time, it gets done really fast. So now we'll just add bunches here and we'll see the final look. So after adding tassels, this is how it looks. I kind of really like this design. We actually do something like this in normal kuchu by adding like 2 beads and then placing a kuchu like this. This seems to be much easier and it saves a lot of time, so you guys give it a try. So I've just left one place where I'll be adding kuchu here. So for the bunch, I have taken 120 strands. As usual, I have ironed it using a hair straightener and I've just glued it on one side like this. So I'll just pass this glued end here like this. I've tied baby tassels. The length is very short because the size of the bead is also very small. So fold it to your desired length and then I'm going to knot it 3 times. So after knotting it 3 times, I'll just pass the needle from below the zari and trim the excess. So I'm placing my finger here so that you guys can see the length. Generally, I tie or I keep the length to this line, but I have trimmed it a little shorter because this is how I want it. Now this one seems to be a little long, so I will trim it a little. So this design looks really pretty with baby kuchu. So this is how it looks. If you want, you guys can increase the number of single crochets here in case you want the tassels to be slightly away from each other, and you can also add small round beads here. So that is one option. I really like the way this looks. It really looks cute because the kuchu is very small. I'm not sure if it looks small in the video. That is the reason I'm placing a finger here so that you guys know how small it is. So this design is extremely easy to work, so do give it a try. And if you happen to try, share the picture on Facebook. Join our group, The Crochet Club by Naughty Threads on Facebook, and you can share your crochet related pictures. So in case you guys like this video, give us a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel and share our videos with your friends. Follow us on Facebook and Instagram. I think that's all. I shall see you guys soon with more interesting stuff. Until then, take care. Bye bye.